metallurgy has, you know, three basic steps. First is the preliminary treatment. In preliminary treatment, we remove the impurities or remove the gangue so that the ores are concentrated and they are free from the most of the impurities. Second is the reduction, means the concentrated ores are processed by suitable method to get the metal. Now, third part is very important, and third part is refining of impure metal to pure metal. Refining of metals can be done by different ways, but now I am going to explain electrolytic method. Now, electrolytic method can be used to refine most of the metals. All the metals cannot be refined by this method, but most of the metals can be refined by this method. Basically, the metals which are in the form of solid, or the solid metals, can be refined by electrolytic method. And as electrolytic method, you know, electrolytes are the solutions or the substances in solution form capable of providing ions, and the ions can move in the direction of applied current. Now here I am going to explain to refine or to purify copper. Here it will be copper or copper. So this can be used for copper, silver, gold, you know, sodium, potassium, magnesium, most of the metals which are in solid form. Solid metals can be refined. Now, here there is an electrolytic cell or a vessel. A vessel is generally made up of stone on commercial level, but in laboratory we can use a beaker made up of glass or plastic. Now there are some very important points, and first point is that the metal which has to be purified, that is made anode. The impure metal or the metal which has to be purified is made anode. You know, anode is positive. Anode is positive. Now the pure metal strip, the same metal, suppose we have taken here copper, so here cathode is taken and it is pure, and copper wire is taken. Why pure? Because we have to refine, we have to purify, we want it must be 99.99% pure. So anode is made positive, that is impure metal. Pure metal is made cathode, that is negative. The two are connected by a battery, and there can be different, you know, conditions to adjust the current level. There can be voltage control also. Now there is the systematic distribution. Now here there is, as I have taken copper, so here there is copper sulfate aqueous. Now on passing the current, you know, on passing the current, reactions will take place. You know, at cathode there is oxidation. And no oxidation, oxidation is the loss of electrons. So there is the copper rod, thick copper rod, which is taken at anode or is made anode positive. So at positive or anode there is oxidation. So copper solid from the impure rod will undergo oxidation, and there will be formation of copper ions, and electrons will be formed. So copper ions will be released. Here copper ions will be released from the rod, and so here the amount of copper ions will be increased in the electrolyte. So this is copper sulfate has been taken as electrolyte in the vessel. Now the other reaction at cathode, you know, cathode is negative, so here at anode oxidation has taken place. So you know, oxidation and reaction, they are complementary to each other. if at one place there is oxidation, so there must be reduction. So at cathode, that is negative, there is a reduction. And so when oxidation is loss of electrons, so naturally reduction will be the gain of electrons. So copper ions here as this is positive charge, it is negative charge. So copper ions, they will start moving. Copper ions will start moving towards the negative electrode, that is the cathode. And here there will be the copper ions, and here it has negative charge, so it has more electrode, more potential of electrons. So it will give the electrons to E number, and this also electrons will be gained, and electrons will be able to reduce the copper ions to copper solid like this. So this copper solid here will be pure and it will be deposited. So with the passage of time, this rod, that is the cathode, will become thick. Cathode will become thick with the passage of time. This will become thick, and this anode will become thinner. With the passage of time, anode will become thinner, and it will become thick. And so this will be the condition. Now below this anode, there will be the accumulation of anode mud or anode slum. This is anode mud. Now anode mud is also called as anode sludge. So anode mud or anode sludge. Sludge means gandagi, impurities which do not take part in reaction. So anode mud is very significant because it contains the particles of precious metals like silver, gold, platinum, molybdenum, and so it can be again used for the separation of precious metals, and as a result this copper is refined. And so here if you join the two reactions together, so here this I'm going to write here, so this copper will gain the electrons, and then the formation of copper solid. So here it will be cancelled, here it will be cancelled. So copper from the pure rod will be converted to pure copper. And so this is the electrolytic method for the refining of copper. Now if you take silver or any, so water soluble salt has to be taken. Suppose if you take silver, so for silver we take any water soluble, let it be AgNO3, aqueous, and electrolyte. And so this is the refining of metals by electrolytic method. But question is, why we refine? So very simple answer, that all the metals are used in their purest form as far as possible, and thus we take. Suppose if you want to take the gold, then you take gold chloride, then you take gold chloride. So this is all about the refining of metals by electrolytic method.